And since that time, we only strengthened that commitment that we have to partnership, right? And what's happening here with Modern is a demonstration of what that power of partnership means. What it means is that I work shoulder to shoulder with Aseem and his leadership team across the company to really transform the company, right? We've had, as Aseem said, the business under our control for just over 13 months at this point in time. So 13 is a lucky number. And
brand to get into the brown bread space with a sub-brand called Vitamin.
I do think that when the original divestment was made, in fact, Modern was one of the first public sector enterprises to be divested. I think the larger thought process was that when Modern was originally set up, it was set up under something called the Colombo Plan in 1965, as you might be aware. And the mission of that was to really promote the consumption of wheat in an era where there was wheat self-sufficiency and wheat was seen as a source of nutrition that was superior to rice. Right? And that was the mission with which it was set up, and I think the government concluded at that point in time, in my view, rightly so, that to take it towards logical conclusion and fruition, it is better run by private enterprise. And that's the conclusion that the government has reached in many sectors. And that is indeed appropriate, and that's the direction in which life will continue to go. Unilever, I can add maybe a little bit more perspective. I think Unilever's strategy at that point in time when it was acquired changed over the ownership of Modern. And I think what happened really was that from Unilever's point of view, this was not aligned to the way in which they were strategically thinking about the business and the choices that they were making across the various things that they could be doing. Right? So it's a relative choice that is made in their strategy. And to that extent, I think they did a wonderful job of really sort of streamlining the business and making it healthy and competitive, and got it to a point where it became an attractive asset for investors, right?
Before that, a short film to share with you as to how we are thinking.
This is a company that was literally reborn on the 1st of April 2016 as Modern Foods Enterprises Limited. Right?
So bread manufacturing units in 1968. Since then, for over 50 years, Modern Foods have been the pioneers of
this that we are making to the consumers. And more importantly, how we are living up to that promise. So all that will be covered in this new launch. Karan, can just show a short film to the audience.
We have witnessed changing times, unprecedented challenges, but like all things great, we thrived through all the upheavals and have established ourselves as an
relevant and, shall I say, potent portfolio that leans more towards in the category. For example, the fruity bread that is available in the market today, and a lot of players are doing that today, was initiated by Modern with you know, these tidbits and the sweeteners inside, and it's a very popular product, a popular part of our whole portfolio today.
About 10 years, and then gone the 11 years in Singapore.